It's not unusual in an area like this to have a large amount of violence. It's just that the hippies are vulnerable, more vulnerable than the existing poverty groups like the Negroes and Puerto Ricans, because they embrace a philosophy which is non-passive, that is, it's passive, and the Negroes and Puerto Ricans are already aggravated and frustrated by the society around them, and they can't get out their aggravation and frustration, so they, the frustration or the violence tends downward, and the hippie is the lowest man on the totem pole, the lowest man on the rung, so it's taken out.
Well, about 4 or 5 weeks ago, about 8 Puerto Ricans came here, entered the store, smashed the windows, and beat the occupants with chains and with other weapons. They ran from the scene, the police ran after them and couldn't arrest them. 10 minutes later, though the police were in full view, 3 Puerto Rican teenagers returned, entered the store, and one of them began to beat a person who was not a hippie, who had stopped in just to pick up a copy of a newspaper, and beat him with a .22 caliber rifle barrel from which the stock had been removed. He escaped, was apprehended in the park. The police returned with him, took him around the corner, and released him in front of a grocery store and told him not to return.
And so it really got pretty bad. I tried not to pay attention to him. And so I ran over these 3 cops standing together. And I asked them to help me. And they said, what do you expect us to do? And I had to wait. I couldn't leave. I didn't know any place in this city. So I ended up in Bellevue. I got knocked out.
Yeah, really, I can understand it. There's people with a good future, they come along here, they become, let's say, I have no other words for it, but a bunch of bums.
Well, all I can say is that I used to live down here, and I took my kids, I moved out of the neighborhood because I saw what was happening to the neighborhood. And you know, ever since these people came down here, it's been nothing but trouble. I mean, not all of them, because you can't judge them all by, you know, you can't judge them all, because there's a few good ones and a few bad ones. But it's like you say, one apple spoils the whole barrel, you know?
Well, they think that we're here to take over their neighborhood and kick them out, but we're just here to live with them, you know, peace of mind, because we can live any place we want to live.